Hi, this is Mike Ash with Plausible Labs. I want to give you a quick introduction to ARC in Swift. So ARC stands for Automatic Reference Counting, and it's Swift's system for managing memory. You create a lot of objects while you're working in your program, and the system needs to destroy those objects, otherwise they'll clutter up the memory, and your app will get killed by the OS. One way to handle this is with object ownership. Every object gets assigned an owner. For example, here, the controller owns the cat picture. And when the owner is destroyed, then the cat picture also gets destroyed. The problem with this approach is that in real-world applications, objects often have multiple owners. For example, here, the cat picture is owned by the controller and the database and the alert. And ARC extends this concept of ownership to handle multiple owners. So it does this by tracking the number of owners for each object. In this case, it's 3. When a new reference comes in, ARC increments the count. The widget now references the cat picture, and the count is now 4. When references are destroyed, the system decrements the count. 2 references have been destroyed here, so it goes down to 2. When the count drops to 0, all references to the object are gone, and that means the object can be safely destroyed because nothing else refers to it. Let's look at how this works. Every object in Swift tracks its own reference count. The first chunk of every object in Swift is the isA pointer, which points to the object's class and tells the system what type the object is. The second chunk is the reference count, which is a simple integer which counts the number of references to the object. And then your own fields come after that. The compiler manipulates that reference count by emitting calls into the runtime to the functions SwiftRetain and SwiftRelease. Retain increments the count, and release decrements it. Swift release will also take care of destroying the object once that count drops to 0. ARC handles a lot of common scenarios really well. There's one common scenario it can't handle, though, and that's cycles. You get a cycle anytime an object refers back to itself by referring to another object, possibly through a chain of objects. This code example shows a cycle. It creates 2 objects, and then it sets a property on each object to point to the other one. If you look at this in memory, you get a situation that looks something like this. So you have 2 objects referring to each other. Eventually, nothing from the outside refers to them. All references from other objects are gone. They are garbage, and they should be destroyed. But ARC can't see this because ARC simply counts the number of references to each object. And in this case, that number is still 1. Each object refers to the other one, that reference counts. And so these objects will stay alive. And if you just leave it like this, then they're going to leak. The standard fix to this is to make one of the references either weak or unowned. That allows the reference count of one of the objects to drop to 0, which means it can be destroyed, and then the other references go away, and the entire cycle gets destroyed. This requires putting in some notion of directionality into your object graph. So you have a hierarchy of parents to children, and the parents strongly reference their children, and the children weakly reference their parents. This is why many delegates in the framework are declared weak, and why it's so common to capture self as weak when you write closures. Another approach here is to break the cycle manually by setting one of the references to nil. This can be really handy if you have a big bunch of objects where there's no clear directionality, but you know from some outside context when you're done with that entire graph of objects and they can be destroyed. So ARC still requires some manual intervention, but it's a lot less than pure manual memory management. To sum up, ARC counts references to each object. It increments the count on new references, decrements the count when references go away. When the count hits 0, then the objects are destroyed. This handles a lot of cases, but requires a little manual intervention from the programmer to clean up reference cycles. That wraps it up for now. I hope you learned something useful. If you did, check out our Swift workshops where you can spend a day with me learning about Swift in depth. You can learn more about our workshops at plausible.coop/training. I hope to see you there.